And it's Sunday night, 9 p.m. Time to summon the energy. What up, your boy? Logan Paul is back with another episode of Impaulsive. I am here with my roommate, Spencer Taylor.
What's up?
And Mike Malak.
Hi.
I like plants.
Yeah, you almost didn't say it.
I'm sorry. I panicked and freaked out.
It's because it's our seventh episode. Yeah. By the way, guys, 99% of podcasts fail on their seventh episode.
Really?
We are on that number right now, so this is our last one.
Why gotta be
me? Folks, thanks for tuning in.
Why gotta be the last one?
It's a joke, guys. We're gonna be here anywhere you
forever.
Listen to podcasts.
We're
iTunes, Spotify, on YouTube. We just hit 500,000 subscribers.
Ooh, congratulations. Congratulations.
Who's that fourth person talking right now?
That is our special guest.
Who is it?
My man, Austin McBroom.
Shut up!
Yeah,
where?
Yeah, he's here.
Holy crap,
he's
dude. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. He's the patriarch of the Ace family.
Wow.
Yo.
Oh, I appreciate that, bro.
Thank you for coming on the show. If you guys don't know anything about this man, you know everything about this man. You are the ultimate family man, ladies man, good example. Like, bro, you're just overall
squeaky
great.
Great!
I honestly don't even know what to say.
Nah.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for having me, by the way.
Of course,
congratulations on this podcast and everything new.
Impaulsive.
Thank you, bro.
Yes.
Sucks that it has to end.
We are going to be doing an audio version only with you after the YouTube video ends. For those of you, again, I just want to incentivize you to listen to the audio version. But I'm going to be honest with you, Austin. It's 9 p.m. on Sunday. It's late. I have no time for patty wax. I Googled your net worth. It's $4.5 million. Is that true?
The results have come back and the lie detector test has confirmed.
Are those things ever true?
That is a lie.
Are those things ever true?
You know what mine says?
What did yours say?
$12.5 million.
That was like last month. That was like last month.
Do you think that's true?
Like I said, those things are never true.
Do you think it's true for me?
No, that's not true.
You think it's more or less for me, $12.5 million?
Definitely more. Come on, man.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
The beard is like worth 12 at least.
Definitely more. Come on.
Is yours?
True? Is what?
$4.5 million. Your net worth. Is that true or false? Is it more or less?
We need
the funny thing is,
what's your net worth?
The funny thing is, money.
I told you I got no time for patty wax.
We need a number, Austin. We're waiting. Exact.
You said 4.5?
The internet says 4.5.
The internet says 4.5.
I Googled your name. It was one of the first things that came up. You know, everyone wants to know like YouTubers' net worth. And
let's just say it's not even a mil yet. So
that's the right answer.
I'm trying to get to 4.5. Okay, just put it that way. That's a goal.
That's the right answer.
He's a humble family.
That's a goal. That's
I
a goal.
Just don't believe you.
Hey, just know I'm happy with what I have. You know?
Wow,
dude.
And I'm happy with the Lambo, as you all know.
Yo,
I love my cars.
Yo, so do you want to tell that story? I think we should dive into this.
So you want to get into it first? You want to like start it off?
Okay. Austin has an orange Lamborghini. It is the cool. Can you give me stats? Like you came over and bragged about it.
To be honest with you, I was hoping you had the stats because I don't really know shit about cars. I just know my shit's hot.
How about this? Why would I know the stats of your vehicle that you own?
You would know the stats because it was supposed to be your car.
This dude.
That's right.
Literally.
And it's crazy. Right. No. It's crazy because before I purchased this car, I had no idea. The day after I bought it, I found out it was supposed to be your car. And you know what's funny? After I heard that, I loved it that much more.
Oh, you're so nice, but also so evil, bro. So evil. The Lamborghini plug of ours that we have in common, whose name is Fang, shouts Fang, texted me.
Yeah.
This was just now. He said, I see you're going to have Austin on the podcast.
Okay.
Do you know he ended up buying the Uticon you built? Bro,
how did that feel?
It wasn't like me going and buying the same car you liked. It was the fact that you built it already.
Here's why this is a big deal. Built it 6 months prior to its release.
Right.
Flew to Italy with my brother to see it being made in the Lamborghini factory. Customized everything. I know everything about this car. I ended up not buying it because they were being like kind of a-holes at the Lamborghini factory.
How so? How are they?
When we got there, they told us before we got there that we could film. When we got there, they told us we couldn't. It was a super, like Jake and I face this all the time. It's like people feel like a sense of power and want to like control. Yeah. I didn't like the energy, so I just didn't do it.
So you flew all the way out to Italy and then they didn't let you.
Did not end up buying the Lambo. Did not end up letting us film everything.
Can I ask you a quick question?
No.
Was it there? My bad to cut you off. Was it there when you went?
Brother. I was sitting there watching it being built. This was my baby.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
What was your question,
Mike? No, I was just going to ask, do you think that that car that you're describing in you know, detail right now is a car that someone with $4.5 million would own?
How much is the car, Austin, when you bought it?
Just out of curiosity.
How much is the Lambo?
Yeah.
You were going to buy it too.
Yes. Yeah,
$325,000.
So would you—
actually, sorry to cut you off. Actually, the price I bought it at was $385 to be exact.
Wow. What did you— did you add something? Did you add something to it?
No, that's what they gave it to me.
Was it the orange paint?
Because it was the only one out here. You know, that's the only car.
Yeah, I do, Austin. Yeah, I do, because they sold me on it, Austin.
He goes— no, still though, after a year. It's been, I had it for— last month was a year. And it's still the only—
it's because
car the, out here, that color.
The color.
Yes.
Lambo has never done that. And they got matte orange.
And they got my boy driving around LA in a white G-Wagon.
Yeah, exactly.
Not one of one. I'll tell you that much.
What?
Right.
The Yeti?
Oh, the Yeti is one of— bro, it's a plow.
It does
on
have
it.
A plow on it. That's a fact.
Look, that shit is sexy.
The point is, when Austin and I discovered that he bought the vehicle that I customized, you know, you came over that night and you were like, yo, check out my whip. I'm like, yo, this looks familiar. Like, why does it look so good? And you're like, check it out. It's got the white interior. I'm like,
wait. And I'm going to give you props too, because every other— listen. Every other Performante, right, that I come by, I look at the specs, nowhere near mine.
I know.
Nowhere near mine because of you.
What's the fastest you've gone in my car?
This is tough to say because I don't really like talking about how fast I go because— ooh. I do have kids. But
yeah, we don't have to talk about this.
It's you know, obviously if you have that type of car, you want to go fast.
You drive a fast car.
But I can say, since I've already put this out on YouTube, I got pulled over on my birthday going 160 miles an hour.
So you can't do that. You can't do that stuff, man.
Hold up a second.
First off, it was my birthday.
Who are you to tell Austin what he can and can't do?
Oh, I just love Austin, dude. And I think the fans do too. We want him to be a little bit more cautious.
Hold on a second.
But you're barking out some orders and—
I mean, don't try to sun Austin on my podcast.
I wasn't. I just love the guy, man.
Are you being serious right now?
Yeah, I just want you to be careful, man. Okay. Sorry, bro.
Hold up.
I love you,
hold
too. Up.
You guys are reckless. And that's what I don't
like. He's not reckless. No, yes, he's a plant-loving vegan.
He just told Austin to max out your Lambo. All
right, hard. Hard. Yo, but wait a second. I want to rewind. You got pulled over going 160?
Yes.
You know that's highly illegal.
I know. And I was so scared that—
was the cop a fan?
My mugshot was going to be all over the internet.
No, you didn't—
I was terrified.
You didn't get arrested.
No, but I should have.
Yeah, how did you get out of that?
Were they a fan?
So he pulled me over.
Bro, I want to give this a little context for those of you who don't know.
That's highly illegal.
How did you get out of that?
So I pulled over. You know, you walk straight up to my window. And I'm shaking, right? I'm literally shaking because I'm like, yo.
This is it.
I'm done. I'm going back to the jail.
I'm
going to
lose all my subscribers. Yeah.
So you roll the window down. Give me your license. I'm like, okay.
Were your hands shaking?
He didn't say nothing else. Just give me your license. Give me your ID. Walks back to the car. I'm sitting there like breathing heavy.
Oh, of course.
Heart beating. Comes back. He's like, you know what? Have a great day. Slow down.
No, come on.
Slow down.
No, come on.
It took him 10 minutes to make that decision because I was sitting there waiting like, what is he doing right now? Like, what's taking him so long? Comes back, says, have a great day. Please slow down. He had to be an Ace family member. Had to be.
Why do you think he let you go?
He was an Ace family member.
He had to be.
California law is 80 miles per hour over any speed limit is reckless driving.
Yeah.
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 Not death penalty, but
I will say
close.
And I don't.
And I was a mile away from being home.
Do you want to know something? Statistically, that is where the highest percentage of accidents happen
within a mile of
your home. Okay. So why'd you have to say that?
Because
you're not
going to
have accidents. I'm just saying that's when you think you're most safe.
Yeah.
When really that's when you keep your eyes peeled the most.
Keep your head on a swivel.
If it makes you feel better.
Yeah.
My brother has also done the same exact thing, as I'm sure you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Driving fast. I've done the same thing. I didn't get pulled over going that fast. I feel like my luck would not be the same, but Jake is reckless. I know you've been hanging out with Jake.
Yeah. That's my boy.
Is that a friendship? It's like, I have friendships like these. Flames meet flames and it's just like chaos and like fun calamity. Or what's that like? Like, what's Jake like from your perspective as a friend?
He's almost like my twin, I want to say. Honestly.
Y'all are very similar.
Because he's like got that edge, but he's still like real as fuck. That's what I love. That's what I love about both of you guys. You guys are real as fuck. Regardless of what you guys have done in the past, you guys are real as fuck and always will be.
Thank you, bro.
Yes.
I appreciate it. Being real is such a rare trait.
No, especially it is. In especially LA, out here. Exactly. Especially doing what we do too.
Facts. Facts. Jake and I, like, you know, like you said, bro, we've made massive mistakes in the past. But the one thing that I don't think anyone can take away with us is that human to human contact, real life, we try to keep it 100% with everyone.
Of course.
And that's why we have close relationships. That's why we're fulfilled with the people around us and whatnot. And I know you have not only a tight friend group, but a tight family, dog.
Ooh,
that's real. That's tight. That's where the Ace family originates. Ace, where does that come from? Because your name is Austin McBroom.
First of all, be honest right now, okay?
Yeah.
I want you guys to be honest. Who didn't know what Ace stood for?
Spencer.
Wow.
But that's all right, though.
Wow. No. As far as like ACE, you didn't know what that meant?
No.
Neither I thought it was like a card.
Okay.
You know, Ace of Spades?
I don't think Logan knows what it means either.
I feel like I'm the only one taking the hit right now, but...
It stands for Austin, Catherine, and L.
Hold on a second. Right? Austin, Catherine, and
no,
L.
No, because a lot of people...
I would have figured.
Come on,
some people
guys.
Don't know what that stands for. They think it's like our last name. Ace is a last name. And it's crazy, right?
Wait a second.
Right.
Timeline. You had L first?
Yeah.
Before what?
Before you engaged, got engaged
correct.
To Catherine.
Correct, yeah.
So you started the channel when Elle was how old?
She was 3 months, so 3-4 months.
How long have you been doing YouTube, bro? A
little over 2 years, like 2.5 years.
That's it? Damn!
That's what we call a metaphoric rise.
Crazy.
Meteoric rise.
For those of you who don't know, Austin McBroom and the Ace family you just hit, by the way, like literally 5 minutes ago, 14 million.
Thank you so much.
On
bro.
YouTube.
I didn't think you were going to say that. Damn, you really over here. What you got over there, bro?
I know everything about you, Austin McBroom.
I'm literally eating, right? Before I came over here, I'm at Cheesecake. And I'm like, shit, I'm supposed to be at Logan's in 20 minutes. But I'm about to hit 14 million.
Let's go.
With the family.
Let's go. Well, you're doing Vlogmas, right?
Yes,
What
bro.
Is that? What a vlog a day for 25 days?
You never done it before?
I mean, I daily vlog, so I kind of technically did it. But
yeah,
like,
you're right. You did.
I didn't make a thing.
Vlog your life away, yeah.
414 days?
60.
But yeah, that's ridiculous, bro.
But Vlogmas.
So for you, that's like regular.
Yeah.
But that's crazy.
But yours is themed around like what, Christmas?
Yeah, so Vlogmas, yeah. Christmas every day of December.
Every day, bro, of December.
We did it last year. And I don't know how we did it, but we pulled it off. And after like we did it, we continued doing it for like 15 more days because we were just addicted to it. And we just kept going and kept going and kept going. What?
I was about to say, I bet your numbers were skyrocketing.
It definitely helped.
Christmas, New Year's, bro? Gold mine.
Yes, everything.
Everyone's with their family, they're at home, they're consuming content.
Yes, but you do lose your mind though. You kind of go cuckoo a little bit.
Speaking of views, how much would you say you're worth? Just out of curiosity, because I'm sorry. I know because we had asked you a pretty pointed question earlier.
Okay, can you explain that more in depth?
All right, so 4.5 million is what they're saying on the internet.
Wait, I thought we already had this conversation.
Well, we just never got an answer.
Not only did we have the conversation, but we smoothly transitioned out of it.
Segued away.
Right, without getting an answer, right? Because I thought we asked him what he was worth.
Yo, brother, Mike, let me tell you something. I'm an influencer. We're never going to tell you how much we're worth, dummy. We're going to skirt around that question.
Then why would you ask?
Skit. Because I don't know. I want to see if you would do it. But I know you make money, Austin.
I mean, we are a family channel, you know? And
can you
help.
For the listeners, can you, like, what about being a family channel? Why does that help you?
All I gotta say is Elle is an all-star, right? She literally, first of all, she has her own bank account. That girl makes her own
money. You're lying.
I swear, not even lying.
Does she have her own IG?
Yeah.
She does, right?
Yeah. Does she run her own bank account? Does she do her own taxes?
She should, right?
How independent is Elle?
Bro, she does it all. That little girl is an all-star, bro. We are so blessed to have her. Like, she can tell us when and when she can't film. It's that crazy with her. Like, there's mornings where we wake up and we're trying to film and she tells us, Dad, no filming.
Because, like, her schedule's full that day? Or, like, what?
She's
why exactly?
Not,
why not, exactly
she's either in the mood or she's not in the mood.
Wait, yo, but
that's
incredible.
It's that crazy.
That is incredible.
Incredible, but also, like, amazing in the sense that she won't find herself, even as a young girl, getting overwhelmed with the pressure of being on film because she knows, like, I don't like how I'm feeling right now. I don't want to film.
Legit. It's crazy.
Dude, that's
it's at a point, bro, to where if we have to redo a scene, she knows when we're gonna redo it. Like she's she acts, bro. She literally is an actor. It's crazy. I'll say, L, can you please redo that? Because for whatever reason, the dog was barking, whatever, whatever. And she'll redo it the same exact way as if it was the first time.
So what do you,
gem, dude?
What do you do to instill, you know, with, I think a lot of people are probably watching you guys and wanting to do something similar, or they're already doing it.
Right.
Like what have you done to instill that? Like you said, after doing Vlogmas, you unplugged. Like how do you unplug as a family and value that? Cause clearly if she's valuing that at this age,
that's like one of the hardest things, bro. That's like one of the hardest things for us is like, and we've, I want to say we've done a pretty good job about 4 or 5 months ago about knowing the balance of work and still having family time. Cause as you know, filming every day, you lose that, like,
it's so unhealthy.
You
man.
Lose it's, that life.
Real life.
Yeah, real life.
You've seen it so many times, bro.
And so with us, we recently found out how to balance it out and got that right schedule that fits us. Because before we were trying to be more consistent, we realized, damn, this being super consistent was also messing up like family time.
Yeah, bro.
And that's why I feel like Catherine and I and our family do so well together. We have that perfect like match with all four of us. Like literally, I feel like we're that all-star team. And that's why Catherine and I do so well as our relationship. People don't realize how hard it is to have a relationship on YouTube.
Yo.
A lot of times that shit does not work at all.
Next to impossible.
And so...
No, seriously, how many YouTube... relationships have you seen ended?
Not even ended, but not shaky. Think about it. Every relationship is shaky on YouTube, right? Or shaky. Like, they say it's shaky. But,
do you look at like I think of like Roman Atwood. Have you ever met Roman before?
No, I've never met Roman.
They are another example of like a family that has like done a really good job of like keeping that balance.
Right.
And I think it's so important like for long-term success for you guys to find balance.
No, for sure. That's the most important thing. Because people always say, why don't you post more? So on and so forth. But us, we have that perfect balance. We like to post, I think we post 3 times a week. So it's like sometimes every other day, sometimes we miss 2 days. But it works for us because we get away. We get to, you know, take the kids out. Don't really film. Sometimes, you know, Catherine's been pregnant for the past, it seems like for the past 3 years.
Yeah.
So I feel bad for her. But she's, and then for them too, it's, bro, I'm so blessed. Like, Catherine, like she lets me do my thing. Like in a relationship, that's so hard.
She let you on the podcast, bro.
For a woman. Yeah, shout out to my queen.
She let you hang out with Jake Paul. She let you on this podcast. Yeah. Shout out to Catherine.
But no, though, seriously though, like if you think about it in a relationship, you usually have, you know, two people who, you know, have ideas, have opinions, want to do their thing when you're trying to do your thing. It's always like it's hard to agree to things, right? And for her, she literally, obviously she has say in what we do, but she says, you know what? Take control. And I like being in control because ever since I was a little kid, I just like
being
a leader. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
And it works because I have my girls and I have me. So they listen to what daddy says.
Dude. And she gives you like the freedom to continue to live your life while simultaneously living the family life, right?
Exactly. I think for her too, that's one of the big things in our relationship is she lets me kind of do what I want to do. Mm. She trusts me, right? And when I want to go out, or not saying I go out often because I hardly ever go out, but for example, I'm being here. I told her I'm going to leave. I got to do something. And
the most successful number one podcast in the world
of all time.
Not just do something. Mm-hmm. Impaulsive, baby.
And she's not tripping. Usually girls will be like, oh, why are you going? Where are you going? What time are you going to be back? Like her, she's like, okay, be safe. Have fun.
Yeah, I was part wondering if she would be in like one of the love sacks watching.
I was
like,
wondering if she
you can't
she would
say
come.
That. Right, and instead right, you right. brought Popcorn,
right.
who also, by the way, is dressed exactly like you. Like
Popcorn is the name of Austin's
friend. I didn't even notice that.
Red pants, black hoodie. Just two smooth gentlemen.
But yeah, bro, that's my rock right there. Like,
yo,
to be straight honest with you guys, if it wasn't for her personality and the way she is, Ace wouldn't be where we are today at all.
It's the perfect storm of perfectness.
Yeah.
It's what I just made up to call it just now. I wasn't sure if you were going to bring Elle. Does she have a bedtime?
Bro, that's another crazy thing. So we're with our kids. People don't realize this.
She's up late, like watching like Stranger Things type.
She's watching Ryan's Toy Review, I think his name is.
Oh,
yeah.
He's big.
You heard him?
He's big on
Shout
YouTube.
Out to Ryan.
Yeah.
Shout out to Ryan.
L has a favorite YouTuber?
I want to say favorite, but it's just since she's watched it, it always pops up in the feed. You know what I mean? So she just stays clicking on whatever the kid stuff is.
This dude's big, right?
Yeah, oh, no. He's, yeah, he's killing the game. Yeah.
17 million subscribers, dog.
Yeah. But no, like, back to what I was saying was, since we're with each other all day, every day, this is what we're trying to like figure out right now because it gets really hard because we don't really have like a nanny. You know, I think my grandmother, she stays with us a couple days out the week, but it's almost not enough because we're with our kids from morning to night and we obviously, the kids sleep in the bed. And so it's literally like our only time to film is when, you know, they're asleep or, you know, after they eat and get their rest. Like it's really, really hard. Our schedule is like, really, really hard to film.
I feel like you could. I feel like there are so many Ace Family fans out there right now that would be like literally dying for a chance to babysit Ella.
Would literally lose their minds, bro.
At what point does the babysit turn into an abduction? You can't do that.
That's true.
You can't. Absolutely not.
You never get her back.
I'm sure.
Bro.
Yo, but here's why this is so interesting. How old are you?
26.
Yo, so that's incredibly young to have a. X-year-old daughter, how old's Elle?
She's two.
And you just welcomed
Alea?
Alea.
Yeah.
So you have two daughters and you're 26 years old.
Yeah, man.
You had Elle when you were 24?
Congrats, bro. 23.
I'm 23 right now. Can I ask you a personal question?
Give it to me.
In the most non-offensive, I'm curious way, did you mean to have Elle with Catherine?
Yes and no. So, we obviously, why all y'all look at me like that?
Well, because good, like, we love a juicy question.
Is it not?
It's a great question.
I'm 23, dog. And I don't know. It seems a bit early, right?
We were, first of all, it's crazy. The moment I met Catherine, she was the one. Instantly, right?
Yeah.
And so when, no. A lot of you guys can say you met the one, but really haven't met the one.
And
that's facts.
Yeah.
So, sorry, guys. So I want to say 6-7 months after we met, Catherine got pregnant. And we knew what we were doing, put it that way.
Like sexually?
Yeah, we knew
what we knew how to have sex.
No.
You were playing the game.
We knew what we were doing when it came to having a kid. We obviously weren't being safe, you know?
Y'all were playing the game.
We were both in love. We both knew what we wanted.
Okay.
Catherine's a cougar. She's 2 years older than me.
I was going to say, how?
She's 28.
She's 28 now.
Yeah. So she was ready to settle down and have kids with daddy, right? And for me, it was my senior year of college. So it was a crucial year for me.
You were still in college?
Yeah. So that's how you know, like, I was like, yo, this girl, she ain't going nowhere.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
Yes, I do know what you mean because I'm that age.
Yeah.
And I can't quite imagine settling down at such a young age. So God bless you.
I appreciate
for finding Catherine. But go on.
I appreciate it. When you find the one, trust me, you won't feel like that. You'll feel like any time is the right time.
Yeah, you're not settling down.
I'm so excited.
You know what I mean? You're just getting started.
And that's the thing was like, when you have kids, bro, people think, oh, when I have kids, like my life is over. No, bro, it just begins.
I love that, you know? Dog.
People don't realize that. People don't realize that. Yeah, it's hard to, you know, be young parents and take care of two kids. And because when people say, oh, I'm not ready to have kids. Nobody's ready to have kids. You just learn as you go.
So
you know what I mean?
With that being said, for you know, people in the world that may be thinking about having kids,
right.
What's like your tips? Like, do you have anything that you would caution people to know or to get with your experience?
This question is specifically designed for me. I want children.
Kids, honestly, really test your manhood. It really lets you know if you're a grown ass man or you're not.
Okay.
Instantly.
Should not have kids then.
But
we're working
for
on
you, I feel like for okay. you're a hard worker, right? You
lay it on him. You can give him the real stuff.
No. Yeah. You're a hard worker. You don't really sleep already. You work so hard, you don't really sleep. So when you have a kid, initially you don't sleep like at all. Like that's not a joke. People say you don't sleep. Yeah. You really don't sleep.
Easy. That's good.
See, he's missing a part of the puzzle though that you had, which is a relationship. Like right, he wants right. a kid, but he doesn't have a girlfriend. So like my question to you is, how did you know?
I wouldn't have said it like that.
How did you know that she was the one? Like, how did you, like, what traits are in your relationship that made you know, like, did you guys never argue? Did you guys, like,
damn, bro.
Do you guys argue?
That's a tough question because the list is almost Logan's like a book right long.
Hold on a second.
I'm just so happy.
Does somebody have a napkin?
Are you okay? I'm just so happy for you,
here,
Austin.
Here.
And jealous. And jealous of not only your subscriber growth, but your family love.
No, how did you know, dude? Like, how did you guys like?
So the thing with Kath and I, so this is a great question. I love this question. I love when people ask me this question because it's an amazing story, right? So Kath and I, we followed each other on Twitter before we actually met. So we kind of knew of each other before we actually met, right? And so I seen her. She was living in Miami at the scene at the time on Instagram, whatever. And I was like, yo, this woman is beautiful as fuck. All right.
Mm-hmm. She bad.
But it was a different type of beautiful because usually girls that are on Instagram that look beautiful, you see them go out, you see them take pictures with guys, you see them do all this like shit that you don't want to see. But for Catherine, she was low key and I could tell she was about her business. And I was like, already, I was like, she's kind of different, right?
Mm-hmm. Can I put a benchmark in your story?
Okay.
I want to hear the rest of this, but I can relate to that. That feeling of seeing a girl who's not thotty on Instagram.
Yeah.
I posted a story the other day. You guys may have seen it. I said like, yo, my future wife, future wife, do not show your ass on Instagram, strictly your ass.
Yeah, yeah.
And like some people are like,
but
it's not fair.
No. I disagree with that. I think they can
so dumb.
No, listen. I think they can show their ass, but not consecutively show their ass. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't.
That's a difference.
I don't know what you're saying.
A girl can always post a sexy picture, but when they continue doing the sexy picture,
he's got a
it's
point.
It's like, damn.
He's got a point.
Because think about it.
It's okay. Wait.
Have we not posted a picture with our shirt off or with a fly outfit or angle?
Here's the difference.
I've had to take some of those.
I made a point to say strictly ass.
Okay.
Only.
There you go. Yeah, when it's just a butt.
Ass, bro.
Yeah.
And I got kind of attacked. Yeah, why can you show your body?
Yeah.
But girls can't. Some of my friends asked me this. I'm like, no, girls can show their body. I'm just saying. And by the way, girls, this is not for girls. I'm talking to my future wife.
Yes.
And so I can relate to you when you say, like, Catherine came across as a clean, genuine girl who is still beautiful, but not like Instagram beautiful.
Yes. All right, having to, you know, show every guy.
Try hard.
All right, it's annoying.
So go on.
So I seen that. I already know the moment I was, because when it comes to girls, I really do my research before even knowing them, which sounds kind of creepy, but I do. I do, because think about it. When you're interested in a girl, you kind of have to know what's going on with them, right? You just can't see a cute girl and be like, oh, I want to talk to her. Like, why do you want to talk to her? You know what I mean?
Well, how about because she's cute?
Yeah, but that's not good enough, though. Because what if she's cute and then she's banging your cousin?
Oh,
you know what I mean?
My cousin gets major.
You don't know, especially girls out here. You don't know.
My cousin's a dog. No, he's a dog.
You don't know.
Well, I guess it depends on what you're looking for. Like if you're just looking to fuck, then you don't care if she smashes your cousin.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly.
Some people are looking for more than that.
So I seen that and then I end up running into her. I met her at this all white party I went to with some friends. I met her for the first time.
Was it a treats party?
Was it a what party?
A treats party.
They
do all white. Like everyone's wearing white party.
Yeah.
She's just looking like an angel the first time.
Oh, she's looking like
an angelic snack.
The sun is shining down.
She's looking like a meal.
She's glowing, right?
Yeah, she's
entree.
Glowing. Angel with the wings out.
Amazing.
So I go in there. I see her. And honestly, I almost like froze. Like I was going for the handshake, but I'm thinking like, why am I giving her a handshake?
Yeah, no.
She's not a man.
No.
Right?
Did you get nervous?
Hell yes, I got nervous, right? So then I go up, give her a hug, and I meet her. But then she like kind of made me feel bad because it didn't look like she didn't give a fuck who I was. Like didn't show interest, okay, nothing.
But when you say who you were.
Yeah, who were you at the time?
As in, she didn't know that she followed me on Twitter. Like she didn't know like,
okay,
you know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Yes. Yeah.
She was one of those girls that only followed like 20 people.
But still, okay.
It's not like nowadays where everyone follows thousands.
Did you have a following like already when she followed you?
Like, it was I think it was like 100K on Instagram.
And what were you doing? What were you
just
doing?
Just from like basketball. I was on Vine, by the way. I was on Vine. So I had a little following on Vine. Yeah.
Oh shit.
Hey, okay.
Join the club, bro. Rest in peace.
So when I met her, she seemed like she wasn't interested at all. And I was like, damn. Like, this isn't good, right?
No, that's because
usually you got to get like an eye, you got to get something, right? You like the chase, though.
That can be
the chase. Yeah. Yo, to a certain extent, though. Listen. So So then, that moment happened and I was like, damn, okay. Like, I felt like, okay, I got to redeem myself, right? Like the chase. So then we left, went our separate ways, hit her up about a month after. And I'm thinking like, okay, maybe she might reach out to me. Hell no. So then I slid in her, Twitter DMs and I'll just, straightforward. Look, I was just like, what are you doing tonight? Let's go to dinner.
At the Cheesecake Factory.
Actually, I was like, let's go to Nobu Sushi, right?
My man knows how to do it.
But guess what?
She doesn't
come
like
to find
sushi.
Out, she don't like sushi. Wait, come to find out, she didn't like sushi and I didn't like sushi.
Great, that's great.
Nobu's got options.
I've done the same thing.
But listen. So then I tell her, let's go to dinner. You know what she tells me? She's like,
I don't like dinner.
Pretty much.
Let's do lunch.
She's like, nah, I'm busy tonight, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what? I'm like, you're not doing anything. Get ready, be ready by 7:30.
Wow, that's my boy.
Took control. I said, be ready by 7:30.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And she said, okay, I'll hit you up in like an hour. Guess what? Hour came by, she hit me up.
That's right? My boy.
So then I picked her up, went to Nobu. We sit there, look at the menu, didn't order shit. But guess what? We had some bomb ass conversations.
That's awesome, bro. Yes.
And that was the best thing. That it was meant to be for us not to eat sushi and like sushi, but we had the best conversation ever. And I really got to know who she was because we talked for like 2 hours without eating anything, just drinking water.
That's dope.
That's incredible.
Bro.
Let me finish because it's
It's getting juicy.
So then after we had bomb ass conversation, right? We're on the way home and I'm thinking like, okay, like I'm not going to obviously
Try to make a move,
right? Yeah. Just met her first night. But I at least want to like let her know that I'm interested, right?
What kind of car were you driving? It wasn't a Lambo.
It was a car.
Acura. TSX.
Kia Soul.
I think it was my Camaro that I have.
Camaro.
Yeah, so, so you were still dope?
I was still chilling. Yeah.
Still have a Camaro?
Yeah.
Damn.
It's the matte black one, yeah?
Yeah, it was matte black. Now I recently got it done.
By the way, the show is called Impaulsive. I'm sorry for all the interruptions. As you can see, we are impaulsive.
No, you're good. You're good.
So continue. You're driving her
so,
home.
So yeah, we're going home, right? We pull up to the front of the house and I'm thinking, I'm going to get out the car, open the car door for her, be a straight gentleman, right? Because that's what I'm about. Like just giving her my all. And that didn't happen because she said, okay, have a good night. Bye. Got out and left.
Wow.
Wow. Imagine that.
That's hot.
Imagine
to
that.
Me, that's
after,
hot,
after,
your
after,
own
after
wife
you thinking,
denied you.
Bro, after you thinking, it was a good night, a great night.
Yeah.
Damn, a good night. It was a great night. And a girl says, okay, have a good night. Goodbye.
Power played your ass.
Not even an attaboy.
None of this. Hey, good job, pal.
Yeah. Not even that.
See, that's a beautiful sign, though. Like, if you don't understand that's a good sign, at the time, you were probably freaking out.
Well, when a girl, like, runs away.
I wasn't freaking out.
Because that means she's got respect for herself.
Yes. What, that she just bounced like that?
Yes.
Because what if she was like, yo, thanks for the date, and then just bounce?
She knew she didn't need to.
She knew she didn't need to.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. That's awesome.
And I realized that once I got back to the house, I was like, okay, cool. Let's chill. I was sweating. I was pissed calling all the homies. I was like, bro, this shit didn't work out. Fuck. So then I got home, was contemplating it. Literally a month went by. We didn't talk for a month straight after that.
What?
Bro. Because I'm stubborn as fuck. She's more stubborn than me.
Yeah.
So it's one of those situations where I'm not going to hit you up, right? So then a month went by, right? I'm sitting there like, I'm trying to look for another girl on Instagram, right? I'm like, fuck, where's another girl? I'm like, no. But time went by and luckily I was busy with basketball, so I didn't really, trip too much.
Mm-hmm.
And then she hit me up out the blue a month later and asked me to go hiking with her at Runyon.
Oh.
When she asked me to do something with her, when she invited me out, I was like,
that's a wrap.
That's it.
Question though. Did you wait or did you immediately respond?
How long did you wait to respond? Yeah.
I waited some time.
Of course.
I wasn't going to be like, oh, yes.
Yeah. That's such a weird game.
I can't text this fast.
It's the hard to get game. You got to play.
Question.
Just finish it real quick. Sorry.
No, I'm going to go sit down here for
from that day forward, we hung out at Runyon. Went to Runyon. That day forward, we were together ever since. Every day. I moved in with her the next day.
So one thing.
Sorry.
I think you're lying.
That sounded.
You're lying.
That sounded very disrespectful on her part. First of all, she didn't let me spend the night for like 3 months. But after those 3 months, we moved in and we're together ever since.
Mm.
But we were talking from the Runyon. We were talking.
You were with each other every day for 3 months.
Every day. Hung out. We didn't miss one day.
Must
that's dope,
be
man.
Fucking yeah, bro. That's kind of that's the stage I'm in right now.
Really?
So I'm like taking notes, a lot of mental notes.
Yeah, bro.
I'm sorry, bro. Sorry, Logan.
We're losing Spencer.
Yeah, he's
we've
gone.
Lost I'm him. Here,
bro. Yo, I'm
happy.
Leading. I'm leaving. No, no, no. I was just gonna ask if you, because this is a thing that like me and LP talk about sometimes. If you had, like, say she hadn't just jumped out of the car and been like that respectful girl. Like, if you had hooked up that first night,
oh,
do you think there would be an Ace family?
No.
Wow. Yo, so what?
I will not.
Wow.
I know this for a fact. The girl I end up with will hate me at first. She will hate me because she will know the Logan Paul that she sees online. She will have an idea of who she thinks I am. Mm-hmm. And this actually happened in my last relationship. Was thrown into a movie with a bunch of actresses and they all hated me at first. I was like the obnoxious YouTuber vlogger. And it's for me, that chase and that game to, like we started the episode, it's like, right. Yo, I'm a real dude.
Right.
So when I put the camera down, it's like, yo, one-on-one, exactly. Mano y mano, right. We're gonna have fun, we're gonna laugh, we're gonna have a good time.
Mm-hmm. Different game.
And so that's amazing. My question to you is, I'm sure, now that you're married, in hindsight, have you ever asked Catherine what game she was playing when she was?
Oh, yeah, all the time. We talk about all the time.
So
she was playing hard to get. She was playing hard to get.
That's all it was.
Straight up, she was playing hard to get. She act like what if she had shit going on? She was like, I was just busy. I wasn't really focused on guys, but you know that's always bullshit. Mm-hmm. You know, but she was playing hard to get. That's how she is. She's stubborn, bro.
But what if
that woman is stubborn?
What if she played too hard to get, dog? And never ended up happening.
Imagine she played too hard to get. I was like, you know what? I'm not. It's not worth my time.
Like, what if?
See, that's scary. People don't realize that until it's too late.
You can't play that game too hard.
No, you play hard to get. Do not play too hard to get.
Yeah.
Beautiful. That was nice.
Abraham Lincoln.
I think so.
He said that, I believe.
Abraham Lincoln said the following. Play hard to get. Do not play too hard to get.
Yeah, I knew it.
Right after he gave this speech, Gettysburg address.
Gettysburg address.
Do you know something? How do I say this? Girl friends of mine. Friends that are girls are obsessed with you. My age, quote unquote. I don't watch anyone on YouTube, but I love the Ace family. The one day you were over here, the first time you came over here,
okay.
Girl took me to the side. She goes, "Oh my God, I'm dying right now."
Yeah.
I go, "Dude, yeah, what's good?" She goes, "I never watch YouTube, but I love the Ace family." And I was like, "Sick! Like, you want me to introduce you to him?" Like, You, I think because you are the patriarch of a family full of only girls, have become like this icon for girls my age, which a lot of girls my age, like quite honestly, don't consume YouTube content.
It's interesting to me because, like you said, these girls, that girl, how old was that girl?
21.
Right.
22, something
like that. And at the time, you would think like girls, they don't care about a family, right? But it's almost like...
That's their dream.
You make them crave a family, right? Oof. It's interesting.
I'm gonna get a family because of you, dog.
It's really interesting.
Well, it's
though.
Funny because you guys are one of the YouTube channels that kind of bucks the trend right now, which is like sex, drugs, rock and roll, random hook. Like, right. You know what? Everybody else is consuming rap music, like all that shit. And like, you guys buck that trend and bring this wholesome, but also really fucking cool vibe.
Right.
Where people are like, yo, wait, I can have a family, two cute ass little girls, a hot wife, a
and
Lambo.
Still be fucking
and still
dope!
Be awesome. So that's why people, that's what I'm saying.
Right.
Because most people think like, oh, you get married and have kids and then you got to like get your 401k cooking, the white fence and everything.
Like I said, back to what I was saying, it's not easy though. Like as much as we may sometimes seem like make it look easy, it's not at all. Like
I'm sure.
Without the people that, my family are, without Catherine and how she is, without Elle and how she is, without Alea how she is, obviously Alea's too young, but without the way, like if they weren't them, it would not be like this at all. So it's like I said, you have to kind of have that all-star team.
Y'all, you know? Hit the jackpot, friend, and I'm so happy for you. Is there a third baby on the way? Clip this.
No, keep this.
Keep this.
Not anytime soon.
Oh.
But only reason why I say that is because Catherine needs a little break and I feel for her.
because she's
gone through it.
I
give all the women who get pregnant, I just give women in general like all the love in the world. They deserve all the credit because what they go through, yo, we can never do it. We can never do it.
Growing
men are weak.
Another human inside of you.
Crazy.
You literally are growing a human inside you for 9 months.
What? Speaking of pregnancies.
Oh, yo, yo.
Stop, stop.
Yeah.
What? You? What?
Well, Logan's got a kid on the way.
I don't know even if I'm allowed to talk about this. I'm just gonna say it. One of my friends.
Bro, you're smiling hard.
Because
over
this is
here.
Good. No, this is exciting.
One of my female friends, very recently, I may go as far to say as today, showed me that she was pregnant.
Two lines.
One of my closest female friends.
Really?
Now, this was today.
She's in the room.
Ah. Like dead ass.
Yep.
She no. actually has.
It's the Olga Safari.
Olga Safari is pregnant, ladies.
Yo, dead congratulations, ass. Olga.
She has the.
Yo,
and she has stop, the stop, test.
Stop. She yes. she showed me the
She's
test.
She's got the test. Do you want to bring it? Bring
you guys
it out.
Are playing.
No.
Are you dead ass?
Olga is 100% pregnant.
Pregnant.
By who? You? She,
no, not no. by me. Not Ooh. By me. Ooh. I don't know, but it's just like
we don't know.
It's interesting.
Are they being serious?
I don't know. I can't say.
That's how you know she's telling
she's
the
pregnant.
Truth. Yeah, she's
yeah,
pregnant.
She's
yeah.
pregnant.
Congratulations.
Congrats.
Congrats, Olga.
Olga Safari.
Congrats.
Damn.
I'm so envious. The reason I bring it up is wow. just because like, she showed me the pregnancy stick. I've never had a friend show, she yeah. peed on it in my house.
Yes.
I don't know what that's like.
Yep. Damn.
But now I do. So thank you, Olga.
Thanks.
Appreciate you.
Wow.
Olga's very pregnant.
But to finish what Freaking I was reference. Saying.
Yep, guys, I'm pregnant.
We do want more kids. I want to have four kids.
You want to have a boy.
I want to have a boy. I want to have a boy for sure, for sure. But now that I have two girls, they're like the best thing in the world, bro. The best thing in the world. Having girls really changes your life. Like changes your life.
Why?
Changes, bro. When you have a girl, bro.
Compassion.
Yes. That love is a different type of love.
Yeah. I've heard this from my significant other.
Yeah.
When I had one.
Yo, what's so great about having girls?
Logan has gone on as far as to say he will only accept male child.
No, that's not true. You know why? Don't have a choice.
Usually when you say that, you don't have no boys.
No, you had, yeah.
Did
yeah.
you say that?
That's
oh, yeah.
That's how I was, bro, in the beginning.
You, wanted a, you told, wanted a boy.
To be honest with you, I feel so bad saying this, but I was telling Elle that she was a boy. I was calling Elle a boy for like 6 months. Before,
trying to will it into existence.
Yeah,
in a way.
Yeah,
like Elle, you are going to become a boy.
No, I was just saying.
Oh well, she was. Oh, well, you know what I mean? Still in the oh. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow, no. Missed that cue there.
But I was saying as she was Whoops. Already out.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Like you know, you seem like the kind of guy that doesn't accept certain circumstances. You know, like
you're a dreamer.
You will be a boy. You will play basketball for the Pistons.
Yeah. No. She was being made. She was being made. She was in the oven when I was trying to get her to.
You want
to
know?
No.
It's not about willing it into existence. You can only have. So if you want a boy, the key is to only produce male sperms. And I do that.
That's so stupid.
I know I do.
Is
you
there a that? Position? Isn't there yeah. a position that lends
they
itself
say that, bro,
most?
But
Logan's
no.
gonna be that dude that has six kids, and he's like, and they're all girls, and he's like, come on, just
this
I got
one.
Get
this
one.
Is the one.
No, for sure, for
girl.
Sure. I can see it.
I love girls.
So,
bro,
what position do they say is for to have a girl?
They say doggy, but that shit doesn't work, bro. That shit.
Wait,
doesn't
wait,
work.
Hold up.
Yeah.
Certain positions yeah. are more
yes,
you're
yes.
you're lying.
I just swear.
Certain sex positions are more likely
say.
To have
and certain
say.
Times of the year, month, day,
yeah.
all that shit.
Yeah.
Wow.
It exists, bro.
Yeah.
It's crazy. But
wow, telling you what you need to know, man. That's it.
It doesn't really work. Well, at least not for me. Shit.
Yo, this is crazy. I need to read about all these things. This
yeah,
is,
you do. You definitely need to do.
Yo, real talk. I've got a little bit of a deeper question. Uh-oh. I tend to do that every okay. now and then. So with the world we live in, it's kind of a crazy place right now. Mm-hmm. And like a lot of people hesitate to have kids, or they're like freaked out to have kids right. because of the world. And someone like you, who you have a platform, you right. have the ability to kind of shift it and influence it like you already are. So like having kids, bringing kids into the world, do you think about the future? Do you think about how, like the impact you have to make
For
the world
sure,
a better
bro.
Place?
Every day. And that's why I kind of feel like our channel is the way it is, because we do things a little different than a lot of people. Like you said, we're really never really had drama on our channel. Kind of stay away from all that stuff. Mm-hmm. Our biggest thing is being as positive as we can be, because we know there's people out there that
have a lot of negative shit in their lives.
Absolutely.
And so we're really blessed to be able to have people that watch us, that come home from school, work, whatever it is, and be able to change their day around completely, you know?
Yo, how great is that feeling?
It's like the best. That's honestly the best feeling in the world.
That's why I vlogged for 460 days. How many emails you get saying, bro, you save kids' lives, yeah, saying you change the outcome of who they are going to become as a human.
Exactly, bro.
So motivated.
I just found this out yesterday from my dad. He works at a camp with kids with disabilities, and he recently got a call from one of his employees that a girl that was attending his camp, she recently had cancer about like a month ago, and she had her leg amputated, and she was watching our videos in the hospital, bro. And she was saying the only reason why she was, as after she got her leg amputated, she was telling everyone that it's time for her to go because she didn't want to be here no longer. But she said that the Ace family gets me through all this shit. Damn.
Yo.
And I was waiting to tell the story on my channel, but it just came up and I felt like it was necessary for me to say. But that's the type of shit that allows us to keep going, bro. Like, it's not even about like us enjoying making videos. It's more than that, bro.
It is so much deeper than you can imagine, Austin. Mm-hmm. And trust me, it goes deep, man. Yeah, you have no idea the lives you are affecting.
It's crazy. Yeah.
So how are you gonna, and we've had this following conversation. How do you plan to innovate and stay fresh on YouTube? Because we've seen a lot of family channels that are popping momentarily or right now, but they tend to slow down. Do you have a plan? A 1-year plan, a 2-year plan, a 5-year plan?
Strategic plan.
Our thing is, bro, I feel like ever since we have created our niche, we've always been 2 steps ahead of everyone. Mm. And it's to the point now where people, I hate to say this, but there's family channels that start to do YouTube, and it's messed up to say, but they almost can't do it because our fan base is so strong to where it stops them from doing it, right? And so it's like, we're like, as people try to grow, it's like, nah, Ace family is like,
true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely.
As like, not bragging at all, it's just the way it's set up right now.
Don't you shoot with 2 cameras? Don't you live yourself up sometimes? Your production is up there, dog. Major, I'm not just saying, your proposal major, video that, was beautiful, major. Which by the way, was the first video I've ever seen of you.
Yeah, you told me.
But, yeah, and I was like, yo, this is not just a normal ass proposal video. There's something special behind.
And we hardly film like that. You know, I told you what the schedule was. Yeah. I told you what I edit on. I edit on iMovie.
You
bro.
Edit
what?
Wow. It was just crazy, by the way. Which is crazy.
Classic. And we still edit. I still edit videos to this day.
You still edit right now.
Yes, bro.
All your stuff,
bro. We film, edit, post same day.
Wow.
People don't realize that.
That's incredible.
Grinding.
Yeah, bro.
People don't understand how hard that is.
With 2 kids.
I yelled at Austin for an hour the first time we met. I'm like, yo, you need to get an editor. You need to structure this like a real business. Yeah. But I know you have. Know you have.
It works for us though. It's not for everybody. I like having control of everything. Yeah. And I actually enjoy the editing process. It works. It works for me.
I guarantee that was probably one of the hardest things for you to let go of was the edit. Like when you gave that editor.
You're giving creative control
to somebody. Like,
luckily I found my editor 14 days in. So yeah. I only had to stay up till 5 and get up at 7.
Shout out Hayden.
Shout out Hayden. We all love you, bro. So yo, you said earlier, you try to stay out of drama, but I know that's not always I know it's not always the outcome.
Right.
Because there have been some things that I've seen people attack you for. And like, I'm just like, yo, this is like a wholesome dude. Leave him alone. But I know there's one thing with people said you guys faked a robbery. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
What was, did you guys fake that someone broke in your house?
No, we did not.
That was real.
Anything. That was as real as shit. Yes. Yes.
Shit is pretty real.
So if I can break it down a little bit for you guys, just in case you don't know the full story.
Yep.
We were actually, the day that happened, we were actually out at Disneyland with a fan, right? So at our basketball charity event, we picked someone who purchased a ticket that we would invite them to Disneyland with as a family trip. So we took them to Disneyland, spent the whole day with us, literally the whole day. We left the house that day not thinking we're going to be out the whole day, but we ended up being out the whole day. So as we got home at 9 o'clock at night, all the lights were off at the house, all of them, right? And we never do this, like we never do this, but Catherine, for whatever reason, she was Snapchatting live, right? We all know, Logan, you know, You save your Snapchats, you post some shits later, right? And so she was Snapchatting live as the day was going on, right? And so we get home at, like I said, 9 p.m. I pull into the garage. Everything was pitch black. But I'm not thinking nothing of it. I'm just thinking it's late. I'm tired. Yeah. I want to go to sleep. Yeah. So I grab Elle. This Catherine was pregnant at the time still, right? Like she's like 8 months pregnant, about to have the baby.
That is super pregnant.
Right? And so I'm carrying Elle. Catherine's walking right behind me. I open up the garage door to go in the house. The whole house is pitch black. It's kind of scary, but I'm not thinking, like I said, I'm not thinking nothing. Yeah.
You hate to see
it. I'm not even going to put the lights on, anything.
You hate to see it.
So I'm walking down the hallway to go to the kitchen. I throw the keys on the counter. As I throw the keys on the counter, I'm hearing glass drop. And I'm thinking like, what the hell is going on, right? Like, you never hear that. So I'm looking around like, what's going on,
right?
Giving
me goosebumps
right
now.
And as I'm hearing it, I'm like holding L super tight. Catherine's right behind me, right? And so I'm looking. All of a sudden, I see the back sliding door shattered. I'm like, instantly, bro, I got the chills. And I thought to myself, these motherfuckers are in here.
You went into dad mode, didn't you?
No, you went into Navy SEAL. Right?
And after I said, they're in here, bro, I was like, my gun is way too far. It's upstairs. I can't get it. Yeah. So I looked back at Catherine. I was like, yo, we got to get the fuck out. Let's get out.
So smart.
So we got out. Smart. We went back in the garage.
Yeah.
As we're getting back into the car to leave, I realized I left my keys on the counter. Bro, that moment, I thought it was over. I'm like, So then I get on the phone with 911 as I'm entering back into the house and I'm yelling inside. I'm like, you motherfuckers.
Yeah,
they're coming for you.
Hell yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. So then I pull them out the car. I said, yo, let's run down the street to the neighbors, get the neighbors. The cops came like 2 hours later. Right?
A little slow. Yeah, what were they riding horses or
who knows
what exactly?
What the hell they were doing. Yeah. So then they go, they say that the house was empty. The whole upstairs, thank God, the whole upstairs was just ransacked. Catherine's, all her purses were stolen. My gun was stolen. Just some random shit was stolen.
Hold up a second. Your gun was stolen?
That's how you know there were some thieves. They stole my gun underneath my mattress.
Yo, that's sketch because they probably had it when you were in.
My house was broken into when I was, I think, 11.
Yeah.
Same thing. My dad saw a broken glass, went into dad mode, thinking he's going to have to stab somebody, walking around my house with a knife. Stole our gun, bro.
Wow.
But I will say, you seem to be handling that a little better than I did. When I heard they stole our gun, yo, that means they have a gun now.
Yeah.
That's terrifying, Austin.
Yeah. No, for real though. And then like after like everything was said and done, after the cops left, we got the report, whatever. No lie to you, for 2 weeks straight, actually after it happened, the week after, because we were trying to get our backsliding door fixed, right? Mm. With like the wood and stuff. A week straight, he can even vouch to this. I was in the living room sleeping on the couch with another gun. I was literally sleeping this.
For sure.
Like this. I wasn't even sleeping. I didn't sleep for the past like week after that. Because I was just so like, I was out of it, bro. I was losing my mind because I was like, this shit happened. And the fact that, I didn't even mention this though. When they broke in, they went to the kitchen to get a weapon. They took a knife upstairs. Bro. Wow.
Holy crap.
It was like, if someone's in here, we might do something to them.
Yeah.
And that was the most like
scary
like thing that the cops, they were even scared about.
So did
that.
You take the same route like LP took after his, because now he's got like booby traps and shit in his house. 24-hour security, booby traps, right. Doberman pinchers, grenades.
There's not a single spot in my house that's not covered by a camera.
Like he's got a mini gun.
I have RPGs.
I have two snipers on the roof. Crazy. Yeah. Right now.
We highly suggest RPG defense systems.
It's been great for us.
So that for that week, as we were staying there, because we were trying to figure out a living situation, because I was trying to get out ASAP. I was like, yo, we got to get the fuck out of here, right? So for that week straight, I hired like 3-4 real cops. And as you know, that's not cheap at all.
No.
Like 24/7.
I'm just going to, can I say how much that is?
Go ahead.
It's over $400,000 a year to do, not even 24/7 security. That's like 12/7.
So I had that happen. Luckily, we found a house like 4 or 5 days after, moved out instantly, got into this house, super low key in the cut. And then, like I said, we had to amp up security. We had to have cameras, everything. Our whole lives changed. And the scary thing was, bro, was when we moved into the house that got broken into, we didn't think we were going to be as big as we were. No one knows that when they're going to pop off. No one knows when they're going to be big, right? Mm. You don't know that. You can't project that. Yeah. And so luckily we had a gate at the front of our house, but it was honestly like the Team 10 stuff situation with Jake at his old house.
You can still get it.
And it was probably worse because people were bringing their families. It wasn't like individuals, kids coming up with backpacks. No, people were bringing four or five of their kids.
Yo, so to message to the parents and anyone watching this who thinks it's like okay to show up at your favorite YouTuber celebrity's house, is absolutely not. Do not do that. There's a reason our addresses are not on the internet. And, you know, we're not saying you're actively breaking into houses, but it adds to the scare because Austin, bro, I'm sure you can verify the feeling of being violated like that is horrifying.
People don't realize
core.
That we've been in a few situations that we've never talked about that were very scary and we were very lucky nothing happened. But like you said, it's just so violent. Bro, Catherine couldn't even go outside to take out the trash. That's how bad it was. There was times where it was late at night. Catherine was upstairs, right? Because we have a lot of windows. And you can kind of see in late at night. And Catherine was upstairs, like going past the hallway in just like some underwear. And fans were screaming at her saying, Catherine. And Catherine's like, and having to hide.
Wow. Yeah. Yo, I hate that
too much.
Bro. So, okay. So
that's crazy.
So, yo, after this type of violation against you and your family, who the fuck and why do they have the audacity to say that that's fake? Where does that stem from?
Bro.
It was the...
People want to make up shit, first of all. We all know the internet is full of drama, right? And the crazy thing to me was Catherine was 8 months pregnant, bro. She's about to have the baby. People that know our channel, we've never done anything crazy to get views. We've never made up nothing. We've never... If Catherine and I's channel was about drama and whatever you guys want to call it, we would have already put out a story that her and I broke up. We would have already done it.
Yeah.
We would have already done it. Simple as that. We would have already done it.
You never take the easy route.
And so for us, it's such a blessing because we're able to film our family in our house. We literally don't even film outside the house. We get to film Elle brushing her teeth and get good views. And we're blessed for that, bro. Like it's that not too many people can say, oh, I get to wake up and literally just film our family living, you know? And so for us, it was so frustrating because people were literally making up stuff. People made up a receipt that we paid actor cops.
Yeah, I saw that.
Like, too. They literally made it up. Ridiculous. They typed it out, made it up. And the fact that it was just typed up very professional, they thought it was real.
I hate the internet.
And then they took one of the cops that looked like he was from a movie and put the two pictures together.
I saw that, bro.
And said it's the same cop, but it was completely different.
I saw that too.
One was older, one was younger. Like, it was that bad, bro. And it hurt us so much because they were legit like our fans that weren't being our fans, you know? And people were switching up on us so quick. And it was sad, bro. It was really sad to see.
It's so sad, dog. And I'm so over that. What you see on the internet is not real life. And I think, but sometimes it is. And I think people have to understand that there is that difference between what people are telling you and the truth.
Yeah.
Right? In fact, I'm so sick of it.
Yo, you got eyes of wisdom right now.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying this, bro. I'm quitting the internet right now.
This is the last podcast.
This is it.
Is this how it ended?
Is this it?
Thank you guys for watching.
Oh, no.
Podcast 7.
Oh, no.
I'm done with this shit. No, I'm just kidding.
Austin, on a lighter note.
I'm about to, though. Fuck people, bro. Like, honestly, man. I'm so sorry you had to go through
that. Can we turn this positivity
up? Yeah, go for it.
On a lighter note, and maybe even a little bit about you and not just the family, because by the way, Austin is Austin, right? Who do you watch? What YouTubers do you watch? Do you watch any YouTube, by the way?
Yeah, I do.
Great question.
I actually watch everyone.
You do?
You lying.
No. I'm not saying I'm a fan of everyone. I'm a student.
Wow. Boy's a student.
I watch everyone to stay ahead of the game. Because you got to understand, you got to know who's in your, doing what you do, right? You got to know. Kath, on the other hand, she don't watch nobody.
She got to be a mother of two daughters.
Yeah, exactly.
She's a little bitch. She got things to do.
She don't care about, you know what I mean? Like she's 28. She got to worry about two kids. She just worried about keeping our family.
All right, so let me ask you something, dog. So you watch people. You follow YouTube. You're in the game.
Bro.
You hear about this PewDiePie T-Series?
I know everyone, bro.
PewDiePie T-Series, dog.
Yes.
PewDiePie's about to be passed as the number one YouTuber for the first time in X years.
So what, you're saying T-Series is passing him or PewDiePie passed T-Series?
T-Series was about to pass PewDiePie. okay. as the number one most subscribed YouTube channel of all time. PewDiePie has held that spot for
ever. So what?
Ever.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying you following it. Do you know what happened today?
They passed him?
No. What? They were within like 50K. And then like the YouTube community was like, not our PewDiePie. And everyone started making videos like, go subscribe to PewDiePie.
People were commenting on our pictures today.
Really?
Please go follow PewDiePie to me.
On YouTube. On your post too, though.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Straight up, bro.
All right, so that's like a little side note.
Right.
What about the KSI and Deji beef that just happened? Do you aware of this?
Nah.
Yeah, like where do you draw the line on who you follow? Like, are they too small? Like, is like Deji and KSI too small?
Or do not give a shit.
Irrelevant. No,
I'm up to date like with what's going on. I'm just not like, I'm not.
You're not emotionally involved?
No, no, no. I'm
like affected?
No. I'm not.
What you're saying is you have no idea who the fuck those two are. Just say it loud and say it proud. You don't give a shit, do you?
It takes me some time to like know what's going on. Cause I can't like you just said, you found out today. Like I'm not the type to be like every day. You know what I mean?
Every day, bro.
But so it's like, not every I'm day, checking bro. In. I'm checking in. Like I'm checking in. I know what's going on.
You keep your head on a swivel.
Like if I didn't know it today, I would have known it yesterday or tomorrow. You know what I mean?
Can we talk? I want to talk about this KSI and Deji thing because.
Yeah, so what's going on?
Here's why this is applicable to me. As y'all know, I boxed KSI in the biggest internet event in history. Did you watch that fight?
Congratulations, by the way.
On what, Austin? It was a draw.
On having a good fight.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, bro.
You could easily have had a bad fight.
As you can tell, I'm still salty, but thank you. Thank you. Did you watch it?
I did.
Ace Family Support.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Like and subscribe. Thank you, bro.
So, let me ask you this.
All right.
So. Please, none of the draw. No more draws. Yeah. No more draws.
I
that hurt me.
I promise.
No, honestly, that hurt me, bro, because I knew how bad you wanted it. You know what I mean? You know that feeling of like knowing someone wants it so bad and doesn't get what they want and it just hurts you? It's like, damn, you feel so bad for them.
It hurt all of us, by the way. Yeah, that was a tough night.
Yeah, but I got to spend a lot of time with Logan in the beginning of the year. I came in and seeing the journey that he went on and seeing like the environment of the internet and the energy towards him, like that fight was symbolic of Logan's year.
Yeah, of course.
Like,
of course.
Getting, you know, being ahead, but getting hit over and over and over and over and over and over.
Yeah.
And then still getting back up, still fighting on.
Thank you.
I know you don't want to hear that. You want that win, but bro. Yes.
You're absolutely right.
Made a lot of people proud.
And everything happens for a reason, bro. Always. I'm a firm believer in that. And everything happens for a reason.
I agree, dog.
So that draw happened for a reason.
Absolutely agree.
You know?
Absolutely agree. That whole experience, everything that's happened to me this year, bro. Yeah. Even the fact that I get to talk on a podcast right now and be like Logan, not Logan, like Logan Paul. I just get to be like Logan to have like intellectual conversations with people is cool.
Dope,
but
right?
Back to the drama.
Yeah, just bring it back.
KSI Deji broke up, dog. Yeah. They broke up as brothers.
Yeah. What does that mean?
Like KSI blocked Deji on social media everywhere. And as you know, or if you don't, Deji is KSI's little brother. KSI was my opponent. My little brother Jake fought Deji.
Yeah,
and Jake and I had beef on YouTube at one point.
Okay.
Were you watching us and when we did the diss tracks and stuff?
Yeah, I seen that. Yep.
So yo, volatile. Horrifying for family.
Yeah.
KSI and Deji are going through that right now because Deji made a diss track, apparently showed KSI's bank account statements. Yeah. KSI was salty, which it was like a little portion and KSI made a big deal out of it. He said he was disappointed.
This is real?
This is real. And again, just giving backstory.
Yeah.
And then Deji responded to the guy who made a diss track against him. And apparently in the diss track, the guy said Deji got some chick pregnant.
What?
Speaking of pregnancies, and left her.
Whoa.
Not a good look.
Whoa.
Was it you, Olga?
Olga.
Oh my God.
Dang it.
Was it you?
Wait, did Deji
get you pregnant?
You were just over in London recently.
This is amazing.
Wow.
It wasn't Olga. Oh no, it wasn't Olga. Anyways, so Deji, in the response,
good to know.
He says, yo, Deji, you are an idiot, dude. You just don't say what I'm about to say on the internet about your brother. Yeah. He goes, nah, I didn't get a girl pregnant and leave her. That was JJ.
Oh, shit.
Literally what? Just pointed the finger at KSI and was like, no, that was JJ that got the girl pregnant and left her. Like,
stop.
Yo, for someone who's been through the brother-on-brother beef, do you have any advice to KSI and Deji on, like, where to draw the line when it comes to like fucking with your family? Dude, because you guys went hard.
Ooh, that line
like,
was
like hard,
never
bro.
Drawn.
Like basically like don't ever talk to me again type shit.
Yeah.
What do you like? Where do you draw the line, dude?
This is a great lesson for everyone. Have real life conversations. Here's where they messed up. When KSI freaked out on Deji for showing his bank account statements, he did it in a YouTube video.
Yep.
In the YouTube video, visually, he goes, nah, see, this really pisses me off.
He's Australian. Here comes the accent.
I can only do Australian. He said, this really makes me upset. I'm disappointed in you, Deji. I'm disappointed in you, mom and dad.
I saw that.
These are not things you say online.
No, because that was real
shit. You call
shit.
Them. Yeah, you call yeah, them and say, course. Yo, why'd you show my bank account statements? Because Deji, bro, this dude's like, who knows where his mind is? I don't think he's on the same planet as us. Responds and goes, nah, I didn't get a girl pregnant. Leave her. That was my brother. Yo,
so now they're on like a journey to the.
So is this why they're like tough to get back with the fight? Is because he might just fight his brother first.
Well, I mean, KSI is going through some shit, and I'm about to add to it. I know about Nia Pickering.
Oh,
who?
This was supposed to be a dedicated video. Now it's just a podcast drop.
You picked a ring? What are you talking about?
Nia Pickering, KSI's girlfriend that he's been hiding.
Hidden girlfriend been exposed on Impaulsive.
I know about her KSI. Gotcha, bitch.
Got it.
Wow.
Now get back to us about that
her,
fight.
Her name is what? Nia Pickering.
At
Nia Pickering.
Neil deGrasse Tyson.
She looks like a sweet girl.
She has 28,000 as of the recording of this episode. She's now has 130,000 after this was aired. So
I'm just saying, you know why
shout
this
out
is,
Nia
do you
Pickering.
Know why this is?
She's just pumped right
blowing
now.
Blowing up, dude.
Do you know? Shouts Nia Pickering. Do you know why this is hard for me? Because in our fight, you know he made it a huge deal to objectify my girlfriend and make me.
Really?
Feel like shit
wore
in front
a
of
mask
everyone.
About your girl?
Oh,
did bro, you not see this?
Bro, no. Wore a mask of Chloe to the weigh-in, dude. I was standing there. I was like, this motherfucker.
Yo,
dude.
Yo.
I know y'all went hard and shit with each other, but like that?
Well, here's why it's extra bad. Again, trying to keep it real because I've been through this beef shit. I texted him and I'm like, yo, just can you leave Chloe out of it? There's so many things you can roast me for.
You even said that before he said
yes,
that?
Yes, man. Yes. Yep. Personally received.
Confirmed.
Ah.
And he ignored me. So I'm like, I was salty about that. And now it's like, we find out he has a girlfriend this whole time who looks like a sweet, like innocent girl. By the way, when you guys break up, I will be here for you. But I'm just saying like,
yeah, that's tough.
It's all karma, man. And who knows what JJ did in his life that he's now broken up with his brother.
Hey, we let the universe do it.
Facts.
Wow. We just out here living our best life.
Speaking of fights, so did you watch the fight last night? I know you called me. We tried to watch it together.
Yeah.
The Wilder Fury
I didn't get
fight?
To see it. I didn't get to see it.
You didn't?
No. Obviously heard about it, but I didn't get to
yo,
see it.
Yo, coming from a guy who watches everyone, you've watched nothing that I've mentioned the past three references.
Bro. He's busy,
bro. You said YouTube. He's busy. Boxing. What does that have to do with
speaking of which.
That's true. That's showtime.
Did you watch the fight last night? Because I told Spencer this too. I came home last night at like 11. And you weren't here. And I asked you, I texted you, yo, LP, where you at? And you didn't respond. I asked Spencer, I asked everybody where you were.
You talking about last night?
Yeah.
You know what's funny?
What?
I'm driving back from Fat Sal's, right?
I'm driving back from Fat Sal's, right?
Yeah. I'm in my Lambo, right? Yeah. He obviously knows my Lambo, right?
Yeah, his Lambo.
I see him at the light in front of me, right? So I'm thinking, okay, this dude's about
he's
to,
just,
you know, honk
he's
his horn,
yeah.
right? So I drive past
no,
him.
No, stop.
He doesn't say nothing, right? So I'm like, wait, what? So, you know, I call him. I'm like, hey, bro, did you see me? He's like, nah, bro. You know, I'm bad with when it comes to driving and texting. Listen. No. He said he was on his way somewhere.
But he wouldn't tell you where, would he? Did
he
tell you where?
He told me.
What'd he say?
No.
Oh, is it getting
he
caught?
He actually told me. I said, you know what my response was? I said, oh, wow.
Wow.
That was smooth.
Wow. Because he told you because he knows he can't tell me. He knows what happens when he tells
me. I had somewhere to be. I was on my way to Nia Pickering's house.
She's in London, G.
Yes, I was on my way to her house.
The Yeti can fly.
Wow. Wow, man, this is just...
That's crazy, right?
By the way, didn't come home either. Didn't come home until 10 this morning.
He was supposed to hit me up. He was supposed to hit me up saying, yeah, we're going to link later.
Watch how good of a host I am. Well, because the fight was so good, which, by the way, did you see, Fury get knocked down in round 12 and come back from the dead? You didn't. You didn't watch the fight.
No, I saw highlights. I saw highlights.
That's all you need.
Do you know their fight was a draw?
It was a draw, yeah.
Did you know it looked exactly like my draw? Like,
look at this. Look
picture
at this.
Perfect.
But you didn't get knocked down.
I didn't get knocked down.
He did sit down at one point.
Both of you guys just confused.
Look at this. This is the fight last night. We got Tyson Fury with his hand raised and also Deontay Wilder with his hand raised. This is me and KSI. Dog, this is... Come on.
Look at your face.
Come on.
Dude, I love it.
So it looks like we hit puberty, bro. That's like, so, what's good?
That's so funny.
Both of you just hit puberty at the same time. They're both like, yeah, we know we hit puberty. You guys are like, we hit puberty?
Why does Fury look like the final boss in like that boxing, Mike Tyson knockout boxing video game? Can you pull him back for a sec? Like that pudgy, bald ass.
No, bro. Yo, you
know, dude, he's a legend.
Shouts out to these guys. If you don't know, if you didn't see the fight, this guy, the white dude, Tyson Fury, got knocked down in the 12th round. Look, I'm just going to say he died. He was dead.
He looks dead.
No pulse. Came back to life to get a split decision, which, by the way, I think Fury won the fight.
I do too. Yeah. Did you hear his backstory? Like, what went into this fight?
Huge on mental health. I actually don't even know if I want to like dive that deep into it. But he is a warrior.
It's incredible.
But at the same time,
where's it at? Where can I watch it?
Were saying it during the fight. I mean, he was 29-0.
Yeah, yeah.
He pretty much gave up. Got into drugs and just was going down this bad route, mental health. Wilder even kind of called him out while he was going through this. He blew up to like 400 pounds.
Wow.
And then decided he's going to fight. Yeah. He's going to get back into it.
Wow.
And he looked amazing throughout the majority of that fight.
Might have to have him on as a guest in the future.
I would love to, bro. I was about to sponsor him for Maverick. Like, got the deal points, got everything. Ended up not doing it, but I definitely should have. He's a Maverick. Yeah, he's awesome. Maverick to the T, bro. But
yeah, you love to see that. You love to see people.
Warriors, bro.
Resilience.
Just coming back, man. Yeah.
Well, listen, bro. I want to do the audio extended version only right now. I'm going to ask you some questions again for anyone listening who wants to actually listen only to the podcast. Spotify, iTunes, it's available wherever you watch. Make sure to subscribe. Get Impaulsive up to that number one podcast spot. Also subscribe to the YouTube channel. But yo, thank you for coming on. You are real as it gets, bro.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's all true. You, for real. Family. For real, family.
Do you have anything you want to plug? I know you have an Ace Family app. If you want to get like what it's exclusive content, yeah.
Yeah. But no, we're good.
We're even gonna plug. So I love this.
Humble.
He's already worth $4.5 million plus. He drives an orange Lambo. Yeah. He's fine.
It's like I don't really need to plug.
You can humbly plug. You got a charity event coming up though, or something? What was it?
We're gonna be announcing one of those very soon. It'll be June again, like it was last year.
Okay.
Gonna be calling some people out like I did last year.
Amazing.
So that should be interesting.
Keep your eyes peeled on Austin's channel, guys. Thank you for watching episode number 7 of Impaulsive. I will see you on Wednesday. Take it easy, fam. Peace.